Hello everyone, we're Mark and Kelsey and welcome to Camp Bracelet Making. So today we'll be showing you four different types of string bracelets. Thank you for coming to hang out with us and we hope you enjoy.
Bonjour à tous, nous sommes Mark et Kelsey et bienvenue dans la fabrication de bracelets de camp. Aujourd'hui, nous allons vous montrer quatre types différents de bracelets à cordes. Merci d'être venu passer du temps avec nous et nous espérons que vous appréciez.
In order to make this bracelet, we will need the materials, which will be the different strings, scissors, and tape. So for this one, I have selected five different strings. Make sure that the length of the string is enough, so you don't want to run out of string after all the knotting and not being able to finish it. So begin the bracelet by taking the strings and tying a knot in one end, and then tape it to the table so that it's easier to work with. Once that is ready, you want to select a pattern of colors, like I did. It is important also to make sure that the strings are not tangled and they are easy to work with. The process for this bracelet is pretty easy. In this case, I had already started knotting, but it is the same thing. First of all, you want to create a square with both strings and take the first one in the pattern and pass it under the other. Then you want to make a knot by pulling the first string towards the initial part of the bracelet. This process will have to be repeated twice for each pair of strings. So in this case, I have already done two knots with the light blue string, and then I will take the same string, the dark blue, and continue doing the same process with the following string in the pattern. In this case, it is the orange. And so now we will continue to use the dark blue string and continue to doing two knots for every single string in the pattern. And when we finish doing all the knots with the dark blue string, we will take the following string in the pattern, which is the light blue one, and do entirely the same process. And so what we see here, the result, it is like a dark blue line in the bracelet that looks really good. So now what we need to do is just continue doing this process until the bracelet starts getting much longer. So this is the final product. Now you just have to tie it around your wrist and you will have a perfect bracelet.
Welcome to the second bracelet that we're making, which is the Cobra bracelet. To start this bracelet, I started by taking four strings that are about an arm's length in size. The colors that I chose for the middle two strands were pink, and the strands that I chose for the side strands are yellow and blue. So to start, I've gathered all of my four strings together, and what I'm going to be doing is taking them and making sure that they're all even at the beginning. And once that is completed, I took them in my hand and did a regular knot just to tie them off together so we can start making this type of bracelet. So what I'm going to be doing here is I'm taping the string to a hard surface. Now, I didn't have a table or anything that I could use, so I used the back of my phone, but it's a lot better if you're making this bracelet on a hard surface because you're going to need to be able to pull the strings very tightly to make sure that it's done properly. So what you can see what I'm doing here is I'm holding the two middle strings really tightly, which are the two pink strings, and then I have the left and the blue string on either side. Now what you're going to do, what I'm doing in this video is I'm taking the yellow string and I'm making the shape of a four across the pink strings. And then I'm going to make a loop and pull the string through and then tighten it like I just did. And now the same thing is happening with the blue string. There's a four being made over the pink two strands. It's being pulled underneath or in between the loop of those strings. And now I'm pulling to make it tighter. And you're just going to want to keep repeating this step. So just to give you guys a different kind of view, I filmed from the top of my hands, filming down onto the string, so you can see that I have the pink strands in between my blue and yellow strands. And what I'm doing right now is I'm making the four shape, and you can see it in the camera, it looks like a four. And then that yellow string is going to go underneath the pink strings and in between the loop of the yellow one. And you're going to pull it all the way through until you have it, and it's going to look a knot like that. And then you're going to pull it tight until you have sort of a bracelet that looks like the one in the video. The same thing is going to happen with the blue string right now. It's being made into a four across the pink strands of string, and it's gonna, there's a loop that's gonna be made, and then it's passed through, and then you pull tight to make sure that it's nice and secure. So this is the end of the cobra bracelet. You just want to keep repeating this pattern until it fits the size of the wrist you are making it for. I hope you guys enjoy, and please show us your finished products, and our finished bracelet will be shown to you guys so soon. Thank you. Welcome to this video on how to make a 5-strand bracelet. Here is the string I'm going to be using, and I'm going to be choosing 5 different colors for this type of bracelet. So the colors I'm going to be using are green, pink, orange, blue, and yellow. So all of the sizes of the strings that should be used to make this 5-strand braid bracelet should be about arm's length in size, depending on who you're making it for. So here, just like before, I took all 5 of my strings and I tied a simple knot at the beginning of the strings to make sure that they're all even in size. Here I'm taping them down to something that is similar to a hard surface, because for this string, you're going to need to pull the strings a little bit stronger in particular. So for this bracelet, you're going to want to make sure that your 5 strings are spread out evenly and that they are not tangled. So what you're going to do is you're going to start at the right side, and you're going to take your most right string, and then you're going to put it over the string that it's next to on the left and underneath the third string. This is going to be your first start of the braid. So once that is finished, you're going to hold all of those strings tight, and the string that's in the middle is going to stay there. And then you're going to start on the left. So you're going to take the string that's most to your left, which in this case is the orange string, and you're going to put it over the yellow string and underneath the blue string. And you're going to keep repeating this process until you have a 5-strand braid. So just to give you guys a different type of view, we are overhead view, looking face down at the string. So what I'm doing is I'm taking my most left string, which is the yellow, and I'm putting it over the orange string and underneath the blue string. And then I'm gonna hold those strings tight, and I'm gonna repeat the same thing on the other side. With the pink string, it's gonna go over the green string and under the yellow string. So this is the process that you want to follow the entire time. The same thing's gonna happen right now with the orange string. It's gonna go over the blue string. As soon as I pull it tight, it's going to go over the blue string and then underneath the yellow string, which is the one that's in the middle. So I know this looks a little bit jumbled, but if you keep going and if you keep pulling everything tight, the 5-strand braid will start to appear for you, and you just want to keep doing the same thing over and over until it's finished. So that is the end of the 5-strand braid bracelet. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you need any help, don't be afraid to message us on Instagram or Facebook. Thank you!
For this bracelet, I have chosen three different colors, but I have two different strings for every color, so I have six strings. I will tie a knot and I'll tape it to the table so that it's easier to work with. This is a picture of how the three-string braid is done. I have used six strings because my strings are very thin and it wouldn't turn out very well. So what I do is I just use two strings as if they were only one in order to get a thicker string. If you guys already have a thicker string, you guys can just use three strings and that would be also perfect. Right now I'm just doing the braid, but as you guys can see, from time to time I just pull the string to tighten the braid so that it looks better. As you guys can see, the three string braid is very easy to do and you guys can do it very quickly. This is the final product and I just need to make a knot on the end so that I can tie it around my wrist. We hope you enjoyed this video and feel free to send the pictures of your favorite bracelets. Thank you guys.
Nous espérons que vous avez apprécié cette vidéo et n'hésitez pas à envoyer vos photos de vos bracelets préférés. Merci.